Good morning, this is Dave Pearson and my wife Evelyn. Welcome to the program that seeks to encourage and lift your spirit. In today's world, we can conquer any obstacles in life, no matter what they might be, through the power of the love of God. Stay with us. You'll be blessed, challenged, and inspired by God's message of hope. Welcome to Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn. Good morning, everyone, and God bless you for listening. Has this past week been a little tense? You say, no, Pastor Dave, it's been intense, okay? Well, I have just the thing. Ronnie Jordan starts us off with the antidote. Wow, is that a really nice song by Ronnie Jordan. It's called After Hours, and it's also called The Antidote. I really enjoy that. It's so relaxing. I hope you feel relaxed and ready to go today after your cup of coffee. Well, let's start with a word of prayer, because we're going to be talking about a topic that's so important for today's young people. Heavenly Father, we bring you this prayer request and ask that you would help us to be a God-fearing country. And Lord, help us to have God-fearing men and women that love you with all their heart, soul, and strength. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, we sort of alluded to it. Sweetheart, why don't you introduce the topic of our session today?
So today we're going to be talking about 31 ways to pray for our youth. And this is based on some material by Dick Eastman of Every Home for Christ. Developing an Effective Prayer Life, 31 Ways to Pray for Our Youth.
So this is so great, because you can take one a day for the whole month, and then 31 days, 31 ways to pray for your youth. So the first one is reverence. Pray for a spirit of reverence. And Proverbs 9:10 goes here. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the Holy One is understanding. Wow, a spirit of reverence, to fear the Lord.
That's right. In the King James Version, you sometimes see it called the fear of the Lord. Also, it's also used in New International Version, and meaning that reverence, that just respect for the Lord. And this is always very sobering to me, Dave. It's always very sobering to me to realize that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. So you can't really even begin to be wise unless you have a fear or reverence for the Lord.
Amen. I've said it before, God-fearing men and women equals God-fearing nation. So what a great thing to remember as number one.
If we want the men and women to reverence the Lord, it really would be wonderful if they start in their youth to reverence the Lord. So we're praying for our youth. So let's look at the second one. Pray for a spirit of humility, which means the willingness to submit. And we've been talking about submission the last couple of weeks, Dave, as the Bible does often talk about us submitting to each other and submitting to the Lord. Here in James 4:10, it says, "Humble yourselves before the Lord, and he will lift you up." So it's kind of a first step, then second. So first, you need to humble yourselves before the Lord, and then second, he will lift you up. So again, having that trust that being humble before the Lord, he is going to lift us up. So these are just wonderful characteristics that we'd like to see in children, and then hopefully again, Dave, it'll be reflected in us as adults. So humility.
And what I get from this as well, Evelyn, is that the best way up to God is down on our knees in prayer. And that's humility. Again, James 4:10. Well, next one, number three, is a desire to be clean. And the title is purity. Wow. Matthew 5:8. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
Do you want to see God? You need to be pure in heart. Wow, and a desire to be clean and pure before the Lord.
You know, I tell my karate students all the time, you've heard me say this before on WYLL, when you talk about peer pressure and you talk about those times when someone might lead you astray and not being pure, actually living polluted, and what do you do now? You tell the person that's trying to lead you the wrong way out of purity, I've already decided not to do this. And it shows decision, it shows maturity, not, I don't know, I'm not sure, I don't think so. That person more than likely will buckle. But when you say, I've already decided not to, that's powerful. So that's a great thing on purity. What do you think, Evelyn?
Yes, wonderful prayer. So fourth, we want to pray for a spirit of purpose. In praying for our youth, we want them to have a sense of purpose and the wisdom to set goals. Let's look at Proverbs 4:25. Let your eyes look straight ahead. Fix your gaze directly before you. So it's amazing to see a young person with a sense of purpose. And you can see that very young in their lives. You can see them beginning to have this purpose. And particularly when you think about them having a desire to serve or to develop some skill or talent, it's wonderful to see them having that sense of purpose and having the wisdom to set goals to try and move stepwise to what they want to achieve. So praying for a spirit of purpose.
What I also get from this is that we need to pray for the young people and help them to know the difference of making a living isn't the same as making a life. So your purpose is not about the big bank account, is not about the big home. Making a life in Christ as the center of your home is the best. Amen. Well, number five, simplicity of all things. We need to pray for them to have a spirit of simplicity, a lifestyle uncluttered. Romans 12:8. If it is encouraging, let him encourage. If it is contributing to the needs of others, let him give generously. If it is leadership, let him govern diligently. If it is showing mercy, let him do it cheerfully. Wow. That's a mouthful, sweetheart.
That's right. And in the King James, that he that giveth, let him do it with simplicity. And there's one thing I would not describe our lives today is that is uncluttered. So we actually have to work at trying to unclutter our lives to have that simplicity. And again, simple goals, simple purpose, having a spirit of simplicity.
Well, dear friend, we're talking about 31 ways to pray for our youth. This is great material. We can get this to you if you'd like, but we'll be back after this. Hi, this is Dave.
And Evelyn Pearson.
We host a radio program here on AM 1160 WYLL every Saturday morning from 8 to 9 a.m. It's called Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn.
The program surveys the Bible and plays beautiful music to address a weekly theme.
Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn seeks to bless, challenge, and inspire its listeners to a closer walk with God and to trust Him for every aspect of their lives.
We have launched a website to enrich your experience in listening to our program, www.SaturdaysWithDaveAndEvelyn.org.
The website will include the previous week's broadcast and information including Bible verses for the upcoming program.
We have included some of our most popular programs, Building Self-Esteem God's Way and Conquering Condemnation.
From the website, you can contact us directly with program comments or suggestions, as well as advertising and sponsorship interests.
And link to our Facebook, Pinterest, LinkedIn, Google+, and Twitter pages.
Visit us on our website today, www.SaturdaysWithDaveAndEvelyn.org. Welcome to Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn. This is Pastor Dave and my beautiful wife Evelyn right here in the studio.
And I welcome you as well.
We got a great song for you by Huntley Brown, and this one's called This Is the Day, taken from Psalms 118:24. This is the day the Lord's made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Let's be blessed and listen. This is one of my favorite songs that Huntley Brown plays on the piano. This is the day. Wow, it makes you just want to rejoice that this Psalms 118:24 comes alive on the keyboard, Evelyn.
It really does. It is a really fun song.
Yeah. Amen. Well, we're continuing our 31 ways to pray for our youth. Have you gotten them so far? We've talked about reverence, humility, purity, purpose, simplicity, and now we're going to be talking about commitment.
That's right. So pray for a spirit of commitment, a dedication to the cause. And Joshua 24:15 gives us some illustration of the cause. But if serving the Lord seems undesirable to you, then choose for yourselves this day whom you will serve, whether the gods of your forefathers serve beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you are living. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord. So that's a strong statement of commitment, dedication to the cause of serving the Lord. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord.
Amen. Also, I put this down that might have to be mentioned here. I don't like to lose, and I don't want the devil to win. What do you think?
Mm-hmm.
And here's one. Men crown success, but God crowns faithfulness, being committed to the cause. Well, the next one we have is number 7, diligence. Pray for a spirit of diligence for our young people today, a willingness to work hard. 2 Peter 1:5. For this very reason, make every effort to add to your faith goodness, and to goodness, knowledge.
That's right. In the King James Version, it says, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge. So praying for a spirit of diligence. So number 8, pray for a spirit of servanthood.
Mm.
It's the ministry of helps. Let's look at Galatians 6:9-10. Let us not become weary in doing good, for at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. Therefore, as we have opportunity, let us do good to all people, especially to those who belong to the family of believers. So, praying for our youth to have a spirit of servanthood. And Dave, I just love this list, all these wonderful characteristics and attributes that a child can have. And we want to pray that into them. We want to pray that the Lord would give that to them. So having a servant spirit, even as a child, again, we want them to carry this into adulthood.
Amen. And if you'd like to get this information, we can get this to you and you can pray this together as a family. Absolutely. Well, number 9 is consistency. Pray for a spirit of consistency in our youth. And this one here is James 1:8. The quality of faithfulness. He is a double-minded man, unstable in all of his ways. Wow. James 1:8. And the quality of faithfulness. I put a couple things down here, sweetheart. Do I make God look good when I go through my tests and trials in life, or live for God on purpose? The quality of faithfulness.
Yes, so there's a scripture example, which would be the opposite of consistency, being a double-minded man and stable in all he does. And so, that, of course, we don't want those attributes to be in a child. We want them to be consistent and have that quality of faithfulness. These are just so warm, Dave, all these wonderful characteristics that a child can have. And again, praying for them, praying for God to give them that spirit of consistency.
Number 10 is assurance.
That is a depth of faith. Hebrews 10:22. Let us draw near to God with a sincere heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled to cleanse us from a guilty conscience, and having our bodies washed with pure water. So even a child's faith, it can be very deep, and they can have that assurance, and they can draw near to God with a sincere heart. And what a wonderful, again, these are just so beautiful to see in a child, have that assurance. And so that's, we want to pray for our children to have assurance.
I like this part here where the description is the depth of faith. Faith is daring the soul to go farther than it can see. Wow, I love that. And then the assurance part, if we aren't secure in God, we're not secure at all. So trust the Lord in faith. Amen.
That's a very interesting point there, Dave, that if you're not secure in God, you're not secure at all. So if you have a sense of insecurity, you need to do a faith check. Maybe you're having a lack attack. A lack of faith is actually creeping in. So you need to be looking at what is your sense of assurance, and do you have that depth of faith? Are you drawing near to God with sincere heart and full assurance of faith?
I love that song we sing, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine. And boy, hopefully, dear friend, you can say that as well. We're talking about 31 ways to pray for our youth. And it's not just little children we're talking about. We're talking about teenagers, too. Anyone that's a child, and you know, you parents who are listening, love to get this in your hands to share with your family, share with your loved one, especially the grandparents who can give this to their children to help the grandchildren as well. What do you think, Evelyn?
That's right. And the grandparents can pray directly for the children. You can pray for your neighbor children or children at church. It's just wonderful things to be praying for your youth. And you know, Dave, this to me, it seems like this supplements the efforts that a parent
right.
has to try and raise their children with these qualities, raise their children with these attributes. It should also be praying that God will give that to them as well.
That's right, dear friend. That's why we're here, to encourage your walk with the Lord and encourage your families as well. You're listening to Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn. We're here every Saturday morning at 8 to 9. So we hope it's an encouragement to you. And we're going to be right back after this.
Keep up your guard for Christ, says Reverend Dave Pearson, a fifth-degree black belt in karate who uses biblical principles and martial arts to teach students to develop a physical and spiritual guard. Are you looking for a Christian-based martial arts program? There may be one near you. Masters Academy has 9 locations in the Chicagoland area.
Hi, this is Karate Dave. I've been teaching in the Chicagoland area for over 20 years, and my course details include basic self-defense training with Christian living applications and weekly Bible challenge and prayer to inspire a closer walk with Christ.
This unique system of martial arts unites Tangsudo Karate, Judo, Jiu-Jitsu Sport Karate, and street survival techniques that provide a fast, effective method of self-defense.
Come visit the class for yourself and find out why so many Christian families have made Masters Academy the believer's choice. Call today, 630-567-9188. Visit my website at KarateDave.org.
Good morning, everyone. This is Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn. Thank you for listening. We're doing a special on 31 ways to pray for our youth. Wow, how rich it has been so far. And we hope that you'll get a copy of it. At the end, there'll be an address given, even a phone number, if you'd like to receive this. Well, we have a great song for parents, at least, married couples. And along with encouraging you with your children to pray for them, here's a great song dedicated for the parents as well.
I cherish the treasure of you, lifelong companion, I give myself to you. God has enabled me to walk with you faithfully and treasure, the treasure
Singing for us, Cherish the Treasure. Wow, sweetheart, I have to hold your hand here in the studio. My wife is a treasure. Thank you, sweetheart. And just thank the Lord for you, too. And the two children that we have a 25-year-old and a 23-year-old, Glenn and Dawn Pearson. So thank the Lord. Well, sweetheart, we're talking about availability next. Pray for the youth to have a spirit of availability. Here it is, a willingness to go. Wow. So what does that mean? Isaiah 6:8 says, "Then I heard a voice from the Lord saying, 'Whom shall I send? And who will go for us?' And he said, 'Here am I, send me.'"
Dave, that verse is always just so convicting to me, that how willing he was. He didn't even ask, what do you want me to do? How long do I have to do? It's just, here am I, send me. Now, talk about a spirit of availability and a willingness to go. And again, we're looking at praying for our youth to have this, and just amazing. God can do amazing things in our lives if we have a willingness to go and a willingness to follow his leading and his word.
It's like those prayers I hear one of our friends pray a lot. He goes, "We'll be quick to give you praise." Well, he was quick to answer. "Here I am. Send me. Count me in," right?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Be willing to go. And you might say to yourself, "I could never do that." I mean, are you kidding? Go where? Well, be careful if you say that, because God might change your heart. And then you will be yielded to his control. But there's things that happen in our lives that you will eventually be in a full-time ministry, and you go, "How in the world did I get here like this?" It's because you had the spirit of availability. I think of that in my life. You know, when I was 10 years old, I never imagined that I would be sitting in a studio with my wife doing a radio show. Right, Evelyn? You can say the same thing?
I was thinking the same thing, because when I first moved to the Chicago area, I used to listen to the radio every Saturday morning. And I never, in my wildest imagination, did I think I'd be doing a radio program. But here we are.
8 years. That's right. 8 years later, and we're still going at it. So thank the Lord. And I even thanked him today already, saying, "Lord, we're doing another show today. Would you please give us utterance and wisdom? And just may your word go forth powerfully, not because it's Dave and Evelyn, but because your word has authority," right?
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
It also strikes me, Dave, that this having this spirit of availability can really be quite an adventure. You're just going to go wherever God sends you. And hopefully our children will have this, our youth and our children will have this.
And this isn't just something that's like done by happenstance. You know, when you go, some people, their mama called and papa sent, you know, kind of a thing. You got to be careful here, because when you say, well, just go, just take off, you know, maybe it wasn't God's will for that person to go into the mission field. I mean, you need to pray this through and make sure that it's the Holy Spirit speaking to you in that still small voice in our heart that this is the way, walk ye in it. So, great. Availability is a huge one. The next one, number 12, if you're writing these down, loyalty.
That's right. Pray for a spirit of loyalty. So when you're praying for youth in your life, pray for a spirit of loyalty. And the definition is very interesting, Dave. It's called a zeal for fidelity. And that may not be familiar to everyone. It's faithfulness to a person, cause, or belief, demonstrated by continuing loyalty and support. And of course, who do we think of from the Bible when we think about loyalty? But Ruth, and Ruth 1:16. So, but Ruth replied, she was speaking to Naomi, "Don't urge me to leave you or to turn back from you. Where you go, I will go, and where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God." Wow, what a statement of loyalty that Ruth had. And she meant it, and that's exactly what she did if you read the rest of the book. It's a short book, Ruth. Is just 4 chapters, but a tremendous study in the loyalty, an example of loyalty. Of course, there are others from the Bible that also demonstrated this, but I often think of Ruth when I think of loyalty. And again, what a wonderful way to pray for our youth, that they would have a spirit of loyalty as well, loyalty to the Lord.
Number 13 says, sensitivity, openness of heart. Wow. So see, if God has your heart, the rest of the body will follow. And that's just so great to remember. Sensitivity. Is my heart sensitive towards the things of God? Is my heart sensitive towards the needs of others? Great. Luke 10:30-37. In reply, Jesus said, "A man was going down a road in Jerusalem to Jericho. When he fell into the hands of robbers, they stripped him of all his clothes and beat him and went away, leaving him half dead."
A priest happened to be going down the same road, and when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. So too a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he traveled, came where the man was. And when he saw him, he took pity on him. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, pouring on oil and wine. Then he put the man on his own donkey, took him to an inn, and took care of him.
The next day he took out 2 silver coins and gave them to the innkeeper. "Look after him," he said, "and when I return, I will reimburse you for the extra expense you might have had." Which of these 3 do you think was the neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of robbers? The expert in the law replied, "The one who had mercy on him." And Jesus told him, "Go and do likewise." What do you think, sweetheart?
Well, a wonderful example of being sensitive to the needs of others, as you were saying earlier, and having that openness of heart. So many, I've heard many a description that would say that he was very vulnerable when he went up to this man, because
right.
That used to be a trick. You would take advantage of the person that tried to help you. But here, the Samaritan, he took pity on him. He was sensitive to the needs of the other, and at his own inconvenience, at his own expense, he helped take care of this man and to nurse him back to health. So, wonderful example, and again, something we'd like to see in our youth, to see them sensitive.
We're going to a station break right now. I hope you stay with us.
"Keep up your guard for Christ," says Reverend Dave Pearson, a 5th-degree black belt in karate who uses biblical principles and martial arts to teach students to develop a physical and spiritual guard. Are you looking for a Christian-based martial arts program? There may be one near you. Masters Academy has 9 locations in the Chicagoland area.
Hi, this is Karate Dave. I've been teaching in the Chicagoland area for over 20 years, and my course details include basic self-defense training with Christian living applications and weekly Bible challenge and prayer to inspire a closer walk with Christ.
This unique system of martial arts unites Tangsudo Karate, Judo, Jiu-Jitsu Sport Karate, and street survival techniques that provide a fast, effective method of self-defense.
Come visit the class for yourself and find out why so many Christian families have made Masters Academy the believer's choice. Call today, 630-567-9188. Visit my website at karatedave.org. This is Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn. Good morning, everyone. We're doing 31 ways to pray for our youth. Wow, do we have a great song for you now. This is one of our favorite ones. And this has to be mentioned here. In a world full of dry wells, where do we quench our thirst? We come to the water, Jesus Christ, who will quench our thirst. He'll give us a refreshing soul and make our life whole. Let's listen.
Come to the water, refresh your soul. Jesus is able to make your life whole. Come, drink your fill of Him, water that lives. Into your weariness, new strength He gives.
Was Come to the Water.
That was songs from Faith Weaver, Kids Own Worship. And that is some material that was used for a children's church. So beautiful song there, very well sung by the young children. We're thinking about children now as we think about praying for our youth.
Well, our next one is number 14, and it's compassion, love in action.
That's right. We're looking at 31 ways to pray for our youth. It's material by Dick Eastman from Every Home for Christ. And we want to pray for a spirit of compassion. Mark 8, 1 and 2. During those days, another large crowd gathered. Since they had nothing to eat, Jesus called his disciples to him and said, I have compassion for these people. They have already been with me 3 days and have nothing to eat. So Jesus showing compassion, and we want to see that in our youth as well. So you teach them about compassion, you bring them with you when you're doing things to show compassion, and also pray for them that God will give them a spirit of compassion.
Love in action. So I think of some examples here of children that I teach in my karate programs that have helped in soup kitchens, who have helped the underprivileged, and folks who are in need. Going door to door on visitation, having a compassion for the lost, and just tell your young person that you can't take the gospel to the wrong address. And just encourage them that way, that love and action can't help but go out and reach out for the lost. Mm. And you think of our burden for the lost world.
And that's one thing I've noticed as I study scripture. Love is definitely an action word in the Bible. It's something that we're commanded to do, and we want to see that love in action, that compassion.
Well,
the scripture, it's no accident when it says God is love. And we need to take lessons from love himself on compassion. Amen. Well, the next one we have is tenderness. Number 15, tenderness. A willingness to weep. That's interesting. Mm-hmm. 2 Kings 22:19.
And it's speaking of Josiah. Because your heart was responsive, and you humbled yourself before the Lord when you heard what I have spoken against this place and its people, that they would become accursed and laid waste. And because you tore your robes and wept in my presence, I have heard you, declares the Lord. So praying for a spirit of tenderness in a child, it's a willingness to weep. And so King Josiah's heart was tender. Again, tender to the things of the Lord. And we want our children to be that as well.
I use this story a lot about children and Play-Doh. Play-Doh. I ask the kids, what's it like when you leave the Play-Doh out overnight? And one kid says, it gets hard. Another child says, it smells bad. And so the Play-Doh is stale. And what we want to be is like soft Play-Doh in the Lord, for our hearts to be tender towards the things of God. And you just need to make sure that in prayer and Bible reading, we stay fresh with the Lord. That's how I think of keeping the lid on. And I think I shared this once before. This smart little girl, she's like 7 years old. I said, what's the lesson about the Play-Doh? She goes, keep Jesus in the can. That's not what I meant. So anyway, it was sort of cute, you know, out of the mouths of babes. But anyway, there goes my Play-Doh story. But yeah, you have to stay fresh with the Lord. And I don't ever want to get stale. And I know if I'm not praying and if I'm not reading the Word, I can get a little stale around the edges.
And also, again, being very responsive, also being tender, and again, willing to move to tears, or move to tears when you realize that people are not walking, or people are not walking with the Lord, and just having that tenderness.
Mm-hmm. Number 16, a spirit of maturity.
That's interesting, Dave, because we're praying for our youth, but we want even our youth to have a spirit of maturity. That's the capacity to grow. And let's look at Hebrews 5:12-14. In fact, though by this time you ought to be teachers, you need someone to teach you the elementary truths of God's word all over again. You need milk, not solid food. Anyone who lives on milk, being still an infant, is not acquainted with the teaching about righteousness. But solid food is for the mature, who by constant use have trained themselves to distinguish good from evil. So really impressive. You can see this even in a youth, in a child, that maturity that they have. And again, this discernment, being able to distinguish between good and evil. So that's another thing, wonderful thing to pray for our children, is to pray for a spirit of maturity.
Yeah, a spirit of knowing the difference between right and wrong. Well, let's do a little recap of what we've done today, because what we have is 16 today, and we have the other half to complete next week. So this is a part one of 31 ways to pray for our youth as a nation as well. Well, I'd just like to revisit this one word called assurance. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. I hope you can say that, dear friend, because Jesus was bruised, he was nailed, and he was pierced so that we would be redeemed or saved. And to believe in God means we acknowledge our own sinfulness and inability to save ourselves, and then we place all of our faith and trust in Christ alone to save us. That's what it means to believe. And God wants you to know three things today, dear friend. He loves you very much, and he wants a relationship with you. And he does. He really has a wonderful plan for your life. And for the Christian, I want to encourage you with this: to discover Christ and to display his transforming power is what we've been talking about today. So let's pray. Lord Jesus, I ask that you would please meet us at our greatest point of need, and thank you for this lesson today of 16 ways that we can pray for our youth. I pray most of all for the person that doesn't have personal assurance in you as their Savior. I pray that they would make that decision today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Well, God bless you for listening. This has been Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn.
Thank you for being with us today. We hope it was an encouragement to you. If you're interested in a biblical approach to life in Christ, today's lesson is available to you. Visit our website, www.SaturdaysWithDaveAndEvelyn.org, or you may call Pastor Dave and Evelyn at 630-567-9188. Until next time, this has been Evelyn and Dave Pearson. May God's richest blessings be yours in the coming week.